们祷告。
Let's pray。
主你的爱何等的长阔高深。
Oh, how deep and how wide is your love。
并且临到我们每一位。
And it's for every one of us here。
我们感谢你的恩典。
We thank you for your grace。
愿你今天早上用你的话来指教我们。
Please teach us this morning with your word。
好，让我们听的讲的都能够得到造就。
That each one of us who speaks and hears will be blessed.
我们祷告奉主耶稣基督的名。
We pray all this in Jesus' name.
Amen. 好，考考大家，请问圣灵的果子有几个？
Let me quiz you. How many fruits of Holy Spirit are there?
九个的请举手。
Raise your hand if you say there are nine.
九个的等下散会过后抓上去我的 office 打屁股。
You should come to my office if you say it's nine.
多少个？
How many?
一个。好。上个星期我讲了前面三个特质。
Yes, last week we talked about the first three elements of the fruit.
先澄清，可能上个礼拜有些人没有来。圣灵的果子有一个，但是有九个特质。
Yes, for those who were not here last week, there is only one fruit of Holy Spirit, but there are nine qualities.
所以上个星期我讲了三个，哪三个？
So, which three did we talk about last week?
仁爱。
Yes, love.
喜乐。
Yes, joy.
和平。
And peace. Wow, perfect.
今天我们继续来看接下来的三个特质。
So, today we're going to continue with the next three qualities.
就是仁爱、恩慈和良善。
Which are patience, kindness, and goodness.
好，仁爱是什么？
What is patience?
就是当人面对到困难的时候，
It is when people are in difficulties,
把痛苦的感觉或者情绪压抑住，
They suppress the feelings of pain and suffering,
然后不让它表现出来，
So that they don't show it,
并且在那个环境中能够坚持下去，
And that they're able to continue and endure in that environment.
这个就是忍耐。
This is patience.
一个人会忍耐，他都是为了某个目的而坚持采取的行动。
Someone who is patient is doing it for a purpose or a goal.
有些人为了养家糊口，即使那个老板再多么的刻薄，他都要忍下去。
Some people they endure the very harsh boss just for the sake of the family.
有人为了要瘦身，即使山珍海味摆在面前，他都忍着不要吃。
Someone they stand the temptation of the delicious and tasty food just for the sake of getting slimmer.
这个女生顶着大大的太阳，穿起整套的制服。
So a woman here wearing a very thick and complete uniform under a big hot sun.
她站在街道上弹吹奏她的音乐。
She's standing on the street.Playing her music.
他为什么要这样子做？
Why is she doing this?
为的就是要赚取他的学费。
Just for the sake of making money for her tuition fees.
即使在大太阳的底下，他都愿意为了他这个梦想而忍耐。
Despite the big hot sun, she's doing it for the sake of realizing her dream.
传道书七章八到九节讲到。
In Ecclesiastes.Chapter 7, verse 8 to 9.
事情的终局强如事情的起头，存心忍耐的胜过居心骄傲的。你不要心里急躁恼怒，因为恼怒存在愚昧人的怀中。
It says, better is the end of a thing than its beginning, and the patient in spirit is better than the proud in spirit. Be not quick to anger, for anger lodges in the bosom of fools.
传道者叫我们要忍耐，不要急躁恼怒。
The author of the book of Ecclesiastes teaches us to be patient and do not get.
因为这个是愚昧人的态度。
Because that is the attitude of the foolish people to get mad easily.
然而，我们知道现代的人。真正缺乏的就是忍耐。
But we also know very well that the people nowadays really lack this.
因为我们这个时代是讲求速度的时代。
Because we are in a generation of talking about speed.
我们什么都要快。
We want speed in everything.
我要吃快餐。
We want to have fast food.
补习要速成班。
For tuition, we want to have express class.
做工效率要快。
We talk about efficiency in work.
买东西要快。
We want to buy things fast.
赚钱要快，所以很多人赚快钱。
We want to make fast money.
结婚也要闪婚。
And the same for marriage. They get married fast.
离婚也要很快，有些24小时不到就离婚了。
Unfortunately, same for divorce. Some of them even get divorced within 24 hours of getting married.
所以这个时代快到让人缺乏耐心。
So we are in this generation so fast that some people even lack their patience.
我们一点点就忍受不了。
We lose our temper easily.
一点点就很不耐烦。
We lose our patience very quickly.
所以今天我讲两个小时。
So we're going to talk about 2 hours.
看看谁能够忍耐到底。
And see who can endure to the end.
我们夫妻之间可能很多人哇不能够忍受他另外一半的脾气。
Many couples cannot stand each other's temper.
不能够忍受另外一半的坏习惯。
Or they cannot stand each other's habit.
所以就闹离婚。
And they ask for divorce.
所以现在的离婚率真的是很高。
That's why the divorce rates are so high today.
忍耐的反面就是急躁啊。
The opposite of patience is impatience.
然后急躁过后动怒，然后就抱怨。
With impatience, they get anger and they complain.
带来的结果是什么？
What is the outcome?
开心吗？
Happiness?
都是伤害
It's all hurt
破坏
And damage
以色列人他们对上帝失去耐心他们就抱怨上帝
The Israelites lost patience in God
摩西他失去耐心他就击打磐石
And they complain about God And the same for Moses He lost patience and he hit the rock
结果就得罪上帝
That's how he sinned against God
扫罗他没有耐心等撒母耳来自己献祭也是得罪上帝
It was the same for SaulHe lost his patience waiting for Samuel, and so he gave offering himself.
所以当我们失去耐心的时候，我们往往就会做错一些事情，可能会得罪上帝。
So there are times when we lose our patience and we make mistakes, and that's how we sin against God.
相反的，忍耐可以带给我们意想不到的结果。
In contrast, if we have patience, we may have some surprising outcomes.
而且会让我们看见上帝奇妙的作为。
It may also allow us to see some amazing works of God.
主耶稣说，只因不法的事增多，许多人的爱心渐渐冷淡了，唯有忍耐到底的，就必然得救。
Jesus said this, and because wickedness is multiplied, most men's love will grow cold, but he who endures to the end will be saved.
忍耐不是一件很容易的事情。
It's not easy to have patience.
单单看我们中文字就知道了。
You can look at the Chinese character.
忍字头上一把什么？刀啊。
On top of the character, you have a knife.
表示忍耐是很辛苦的。
It means it's hard to endure.
一定要付出代价。
There is a price to pay.
刚才姐妹所读的经文不但如此就是在患难中也是欢欢喜喜的因为知道患难生忍耐忍耐生老念老念生盼望盼望不至于羞耻因为所赐给我们的圣灵将神的爱浇灌在我们心里
In the Bible passage read by Sister T. Elia It says More than that We rejoice in our sufferings Knowing that suffering produces endurance And endurance produces character, and character produces hope. And hope does not disappoint us because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit which has been given to us.
所以今天我们在患难中更需要有更多的忍耐。
That's why nowadays we need more patience and endurance in the midst of difficulties and sufferings.
而我们基督徒我们忍耐的原因就是因为我们知道主会再来。
And the main reason for us Christians to be patient today here is that we know very well that Jesus is coming back.
那是我们最终极的盼望。
That is our ultimate hope.
所以我们要学习从将来看现在。
That's why we need to learn to look at things from the future perspective.
以主耶稣的得胜、他的复活的盼望、永恒的生命来看我们现今所面对的一切。
We need to look at the victory and the power of resurrection to look at things nowadays.
如果我们能够这样子做的话，我们不论是在学业上、工作上、人际关系上、家庭上、侍奉上，遇到任何的挑战、问题，我们都会忍耐 坚持。
Only then we can choose patience and endure in spite of the difficulties we have in our studies, in our work, in our relationships, in our family and ministries.
因为我们相信有一天上帝的旨意会成就。Amen.
Only because we believe that one day our Lord's will be done.
所以弟兄姐妹，忍耐不是速成的。
So brothers and sisters, patience is no shortcut.
你是需要经历一些事情而学习的功课。
It's a lesson we need to learn through different experiences.
而那些事情往往都是一些很困难、很艰难，或者是一些患难。
And most of those experiences may be tough and difficult.
正如我们所读的经文，患难生忍耐。
Just like the Bible verse that we've read, suffering produces endurance.
所以跟隔壁的说，患难生忍耐。
Tell the person next to you, Suffering produces endurance.
第二点，恩慈。
The next point.
哥林多前书我们很熟悉的经文，爱是恒久，忍耐又有恩慈。
This is a very familiar passage in 1 Corinthians 13 verse 4. Love is patient and kind.
恩慈就是待人有爱心，有怜悯的心，有仁慈。
So kindness here means the morality of understanding and having mercy and compassion to others.
而且圣经中往往讲到的恩慈都是上帝的恩慈。
In the Bible, we see this kindness, and it's always related to God.
恩慈有两方面，我们是可以学习的。
There are two perspectives of kindness that we can learn.
一方面是在人的需要上有恩慈。
The first perspective, we can have kindness to humans.
另外一方面是要在人的过失上有恩慈。
Second, we need to have kindness in terms of people's mistakes and, the wrong paths.
所以首先我们来看在人的需要上有恩慈。
So first, we look at having kindness on the needs of people.
正如大卫他所写的一首诗，诗篇。二十三篇，我们都很熟悉的，讲到我一生一世必有恩惠慈爱随着我，我且要住在耶和华的殿中，直到永远。
In Psalm 23, verse 6, written by David, Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
我们的上帝是恩慈的上帝。
Our God is a God of kindness.
他今天能够看见我们每一个人的需要。
He can see.All our needs today.
而且他会按照美好的旨意来帮助我们。
And he helps us according to his good will.
他借着耶稣基督完全的向我们展示出来。
He demonstrates that through Jesus.
耶稣走遍各城各乡的时候，他在会堂里教训人，然后宣讲天国的福音，又医治各样的病症，然后他看见许多的人，他就怜悯他们，因为他们困苦流离，如同羊没有牧人一般。
So Jesus walked across the towns and villages. When he saw the crowds, he had compassion for them because they were harassed and helpless, like sheep without a shepherd.
然后又有两个瞎子来到耶稣面前，大喊：“大卫子孙啊，你可怜我们吧！”
And there were two blind men, knowing Jesus' presence, and they cried out to him, "Oh, Son of David, have mercy on us."
然后众人又阻止他们：“嘘，不要乱喊乱叫，不要乱喊乱叫。”
The crowd.Hush them, trying to stop them.
他们喊得更大声，大卫的子孙啊，可怜我们吧。
But even then, they cried even louder, "Have mercy on us, Son of David."
所以耶稣就问他们，你们要什么
？And Jesus asked them, "What do you want?"
他们说，我们要看见。
They say, "We want to see."
所以经文说，耶稣就动了慈心，把他们的眼睛一摸，他们立刻看见，就跟从了耶稣。
And the Bible says, Jesus in pity.Touched their eyes, and immediately they received their sight and followed him.
So, 主耶稣他的恩慈的行动就是看见对方的需要。
So, Jesus' response of kindness is to see the needs of people.
有个少年人，他跟他爸爸去要去看马戏团。
So, a young man went to a circus with his father.
到了那里，他们就排队要买戏品那个马戏团的票。
When they got there, they started lining up to get the ticket.
哇，排了老半天， 终于轮到他们了。
So after a very long queue, it was finally their turn.
就前面刚好有一位啊，有一个家庭。
There was a family in front of them.
然后一对的夫妻带着八个孩子。
And the family was a couple with 8 children.
穿起来很简单。
Their clothes looked simple.
看起来应该没有什么钱。
They didn't look very wealthy.
啊，那个八个孩子，他们都很有秩序的，都肩并肩，都排好队，就等买戏票。
But the 8 kids were very well behaved, lining up, shoulder by shoulder, and yeah, they all looked clean and neat.
然后他们也都很兴奋，都一直在谈论着，哇，等一下马戏团有什么东西啊，有什么东西。
Yeah, they were all excited about the circus, talking about the things they might see there.
然后那个前面的那个家庭，那个父亲就问那个售票员，一张票多少钱？
So the father asked the ticket seller, how much is the ticket?
我要买两个大人，八个小孩子的票。
I need 2 tickets for adults and 8 tickets for children.
当那个售票员一讲出那个数目的时候，吓到那个父亲。
When the counter told the father how much it cost, the father was shocked.
然后原本是很兴奋的这个表情，突然变得很忧愁。
So the father's face turned from excitement to sorrow.
然后他再跟那个售票员确认一下，请问是多少钱？
But once again, he asked for confirmation with the ticket seller. How much again?
他真的没有听错那个价钱，结果他的脸真的是沉了下来。
He was sure of the price now, and he was even sadder.
排在后面的少年人跟他爸爸，他看到了这一切。
So the young man and his father saw everything.
然后爸爸就从他口袋里拿出他们仅有的一张100块，然后故意让他掉在地上。
And the young man's father decided to pull out a note of $100 from his pocket and just dropped it on the floor.
然后那个爸爸就拍拍前面那个爸爸啊，就跟他说：“哎，先生，你掉了钱。”
And he tapped the shoulder of the father in front of them. Oh, excuse me, sir, did you drop the money?
当然，前面那个父亲他知道发生什么事情。
Of course, the father knew well what was happening.
所以他很感激的就抓着那个后面那个爸爸的手，谢谢他。
He was so thankful. He grabbed the shoulder of the young man's father, thanking him.
他说：“谢谢你，这对我们一家意义非常重大。”
Thank you so much, sir. This means a lot to our family.
虽然最后后面那个少年人跟他爸爸没有钱买戏票了嘛，因为唯有一张100块嘛。
Even though the young man and his father did not have more money to watch the show anymore,
但是因为他们恩慈的行动祝福了前面这个家庭。
But their kindness has blessed one family.
弟兄姐妹，
So brothers and sisters,
你今天有看见人的需要吗？
Do you see the needs of other people today?
我们每次来教会的时候，你有看到他人的需要吗？
When we come to church every time, do we see the needs of other people?
还是你只看到我的需要？
Or do you only see your own needs?
今天我要从牧师的身上得到什么？我要从弟兄姐妹的身上得到什么？
Yes, today I want to get something from pastor. Oh, today I'm going to get something from brothers and sisters.
还是因着这个时代的变迁，我们人变得越来越冷酷？
Or are we become more and more indifferent?
越来越没有人情味。
Are we losing more and more humanity as time goes?
看到其他人有需要，我们都无动于衷。
Even when we see the needs of other people, we don't feel anything.
身为上帝的儿女，我们身上应该要流露出主耶稣的那个恩慈。
As the children of God, we should have the kindness of God with us.
这个社会再冷酷无情，但是我们更要活出那个恩慈来融化这个冷漠的时代。
Yes, the colder the society is today, the more we need to live out the patience, I mean the kindness of God.
所以求主打开我们的眼睛。
Yes, may the Lord open our eyes.
今天你是看见别人的需要，还是看到别人可以从别人身上得到什么东西？
Do we see the needs of other people, or do we see what we can get from others?
所以跟隔壁的说，要看见别人的需要。
Tell the person next to you, we need to see the needs of others.
然后第二，就是要在人的过失上有恩慈。
Second, we need to have kindness in the fault of others.
出埃及记33:19讲到耶和华说我要显出我一切的恩慈在你面前经过宣告我的名我要恩待谁就恩待谁要怜悯谁就怜悯谁
Exodus 33:19 says And he said I'll make all my goodness pass before you And will proclaim before you my name the Lord And I'll be gracious to whom I'll be gracious And will show mercy on whom I'll show mercy
以弗所书4:32讲到并要以恩慈相待存怜悯的心彼此饶恕正如神在基督里饶恕了你们一样
Ephesians 4:32 says And be kind to one another, tender hearted Forgiving one another as God in Christ forgave you
上帝不单单看见人的需要他也体恤人的软弱
Not only God is able to see the needs of others He's also able to compassionhave compassion on others.
他要用恩慈来帮助人悔改，引导他们走在正直的道路上。
He uses his own kindness to help people to correct themselves and guide them onto the right path.
虽然以色列人他们一次又一次的在得罪上帝
，Even though the Israelites sinned against God over and over,
但是上帝还是一样恩待他们。
God still treated them with kindness.
很少是立刻降下惩罚了。
Very seldom God punished them right away.
所以那些误会上，那些讲上帝旧约的上帝是很残忍的，其实是一个很大的误会。
So it's a huge misunderstanding for people to say that the God of Old Testament was very cruel.
如果有人这样子说的话，你可以请他回去看那个时间点。你看上帝忍了以色列人多久
If someone says that to you that oh, God of Old Testament is so cruel please ask them to look back at the book of Old Testament and see how long God had been patient with us
往往都是几百年了
It was usually hundreds of years
所以上帝都是希望人有机会可以回转
So our God is always hoping usto return to him.
所以他总是给机会，总是给时间。
That's why he always gives us chances. He always gives us time.
有些人想要对人恩慈，却有心无力。
Some people want to be kind to others, but they just cannot do it.
一旦别人触动到他的时候，他还是会忍不住破口大骂。
When people make them angry, they just scold them back easily.
但是恩慈不是一个想法，它是一个行动来的。
But kindness is not only a thought, it's an action.
恩慈不会得理不饶人的。
Kindness doesn't simply treat each other without reasoning.
反而在忍耐过后，他会主动的去鼓励、去饶恕、去帮助那个人。
Instead, after reasoning, people with kindness goes to people.And show them kindness and patience.
你可以想一下，可能过去有谁得罪过你的
？Can you think back who has sinned against you in the past?
你有用恩慈来待他吗
？And did you treat them with kindness?
如果没有的话，今天开始。
If not, we can start from today.
还来得及的。
Yes, it's not too late.
所以不要用自己的眼光、自己的标准来看人。
So please do not treat others with your own standards.
用上帝的眼光，用上帝的标准来看人。
But we should treat others with God's standard.
因为上帝怜悯我们这样子那么烂的人，他也要我们去怜悯那些软弱的人。
Because God has forgiven us such wretched and messy people, we should even more so do the same with others.
最后一点
，Lastly，
就是良善
，Goodness。
恩慈跟良善有一点相似。
Yes, kindness and goodness are similar.
恩慈是爱心所发出的行动。
Well, kindness is an action from the heart with love.
良善则是一个形容一个人行善的特性。
But goodness is more of the characteristics of a person who does kindness.
当我们说一个人很良善的时候，表示什么
？When we say someone with goodness.What does it mean?
啊，比如说，啊，很善良，良善，很善良。OK， 倒转来，
right.
可以用的，可以这样子用的。
Yes, goodness. Okay. Well, yeah, it's also similar to kindness.
通常 不过我们很少用良善啦。
We seldom use this word goodness.
其实我们都会说他是一个好人。
Yeah, we usually say, oh, he's a kind person.
这样今天我们怎样定义一个好人？
So how do we define a good person?
啊，你今天怎样定义那个就是一个好人？
Yes, what's your definition of a good person?
不是坏人，没有做坏事啊，没有做坏事。
Not a bad guy. Yes, not a bad guy.
啊，不撒谎，不偷东西。
A person who doesn't commit crimes, a person who doesn't lie, who doesn't steal.
但不只是这样，还要有一点positive 的 action, 就是有爱心，可能会帮助人这样子。
Right, not only that, but there should also be some positive actions, like helpful and loving.
其实一个人良善不是那个人对我们或者对他人多好。
Well, a person who is good is not up to whether or not they are good to us.
或者他有没有奉公守法。
Or he's abiding the laws.
因为一个人良不良善是用上帝的标准来定的。
A person who is good or not should not be judged by our own standards, but the Lord's standards.
就好像在路加福音有一个少年的官，他来找耶稣嘛。
It's like the young man in the book of Luke who came to Jesus.
他就称耶稣良善的夫子啊。
And he called Jesus, oh, kind, a good teacher.
但是耶稣说什么？除了神一位以外，没再也没有良善的。
But Jesus replied him, no one is good but God alone.
所以以上帝的标准来看，没有一个人是良善的。
So according to God's standard, there is no one who is good.
虽然如此，但是上帝还是要我们去学习成为良善的。
Even then,God still expects us to learn to be good and to do goodness.
因为上帝是良善，所以他要我们跟从他的，学习他的良善。
Because our God shows goodness, that's why he also expects us to do the same.
所以一个良善的人，他不单单是行好事而已。
So a man with goodness is not only a person who does kindness.
他有时在面对一些不公不义的事情上，或者他面对到一些恶事上，他是有原则的，不要去做或者去阻止。
Even more so, when he is facing something injustice, he is able to reject the wickedness with his own principles.
因为一个人可以做一切别人看来是好的事情，但是不一定是良善。相反的，可能别人觉得他做的事情是很残忍的，但是可能是良善的。
Because someone can do something good in the eyes of other people, but that might not be something good. On the other hand, someone can do something very cruel and brutal in the eyes of others, but that might be a good action.
有一个家庭，夫妻俩都非常爱主。
There is a family with couple who love God.
他们的孩子都在国外念名校。
They have children studying abroad.
然后也考得非常好的成绩。
And they also get very good results.
毕业过后就回来了。
And they come back home after study.
回来过后要做什么？
And what do they do after they come back from overseas?
做工咯，爸爸妈妈的心都是这样子想的嘛。
Yes.
供了你这样多年，供了你，给了你那么多钱去读书。
Yes, of course, he's expected to work after, you know, the parents sponsoring him and supporting him overseas so many years.
回来的时候，这边做做啊，不要做了；那边做做，哎，不要做了。
And this son, this child comes back from overseas and he's changed many jobs.
最后他发现到在家里做最好，啃老族，做啃老族。
Eventually, he realized that, oh, it's best to be a neat at home.
但是 这对夫妻当然是劝他的孩子咯，你要去出去做工，不可以这样子的，不可以整天在家黑的。
Of course, the couple, the parents tried to advise him, oh, you shouldn't just stay home, you should do something outside.
怎样都不要出去做工。
But the child just wouldn't listen to the parents.
但是父母就忍下心了。
And so the parents finally decided,
把这个孩子赶出去。
They should chase this child away from home.
但在所有的父母的眼里， 看来这个父母很残忍呢，这么难也可以赶孩子出去的。
Yes, it looks very cruel in the eyes of many parents. How dare you chasing your own child away from home?
但是他们说，他都差不多要三十岁人了。
But the couple said, "Come on, he's already 27 years old."
如果我不赶他出去
，If I don't chase him, if I don't ask him out,
一直养着他，他就会觉得这个是理所当然的。
And we keep raising him.And he might take it for granted.
他就会越来越颓废，越来越没有责任感，成为一个社会的寄生虫。
And he will only be more and more useless and lacks his own responsibility.
所以凡事都 yes 都 OK 的，凡事都讨好人的，不一定是良善的。
So someone who always says yes may not be a good person.
良善的人是能够分辨是非对错。
A good person is someone who is able to distinguish good and wrong.
就好像上帝这样子，他是会让他的儿女面对挫折的。
It's just the same as God. God allows his own children to face difficulties.
他会让那些不听话的儿女受到其他人的鞭打的。
He also allows his children to face punishment.
所以为什么我们要成为一个良善的人呢
？So why should we become someone with goodness？
我们不是要积德，不是要行善而已，不是要得到别人的认可。
We don't want to be good just to accumulate merits or to get recognition from others。
因为这个是我们生命应该流露出来的。
But because this is something we should have in our life。
虽然我今天拆解出来我们。拆了九个特质出来嘛
？Even though we have broken down the nine qualities，
但是我们还是要回到圣灵所结的那粒果子。
Yes, we should still return to the Holy Spirit, to the fruit of the Holy Spirit.
所以这个是我们应该要活出来的。
Yes, so this is what we should live out in our life.
好吧，我们一起来读约翰三书一章十一节，来中文的，然后到英文的，一二三。不要效法。
English, John 3, chapter 1, verse 11. Beloved, do not imitate evil, but imitate good. He who does good is of God. He who does evil has not seen God.
很多人说基督徒都是好人。
A lot of people say that, oh, all Christians are good guys.
你会笑吗？笑，为什么？
Do you laugh at it?
真正实情的人都知道，基督徒里面很多坏人。
Because we know there are many bad guys among us.
对，上帝说没有一个人是良善的。
That's why Jesus said no one is good.
但是他要我们不要放弃去追求那个良善。
But God wants us to never give up, and we should strive to be good.
而且主耶稣也提醒我们，也鼓励我们不要灰心。
And Jesus also keeps encouraging us not to give up, not to quit.
经文讲到，我们行善不可丧志，若不灰心，到了时候就要收成了。
The Bible also tells us in Galatians, and let us not grow weary in well-doing, for in due season we shall reap, if we do not lose heart.
所以可能我们今天所做的，可能你觉得是很微不足道的东西。
So maybe what you do today, you think what you do today is little and tiny.
但都不可以停止去行善。
Even then, please don't give up. Please stop. Please don't stop doing it.
因为时候到了，上帝会亲自的赐福我们。
When the time is right, God will reward you yourself.
有个女士，她在一家那个肉类的加工厂工作。
There is a woman working in a meat process factory.
有一天要下班之前，她走进那个冷库那个房里面去做一些检查。
So one day before going home, she has her usual rounds checking the freezer.
然后突然那个冷库的房的门突然关了。
All of a sudden, the door of the freezer room just shut.
哇，她反锁在里面。
She was locked inside.
她怎样喊怎样叫，外面的人都听不到。
Nobody can hear her from the outside, no matter how she cries, how she screams.
然后她看看时钟，哇，这时间大多数的人都下班了。
And she looked at the time. It's already, you know, after work, everyone's gone.
哇，她还是不放弃的，一直在喊，一直在叫，但是还是没有人听到。
But she doesn't give up. She keeps screaming. She keeps shouting.
几个小时过后，她差不多是要，就是要冻死在那个冷库房里面了。
A few hours later, she's almost, dying because of the cold.
在紧要关头的时候，哎，那个工厂的保安把那个冷库房的门打开了。
But suddenly, the security of the factory just opened the door.
后来他问那个保安，你为什么会去打开那个门？
And after that, she asked the security, why would you open the door?
因为一般上保安都不会进去的，都是在门口的嘛。
Because, you know, the security is usually at the entrance of the factory.They don't usually go into the factory.
那个保安就说，我在这家的工厂工作了35年了。
And the security explains to her that I've been working at this factory for more than 30 years.
每天都有几百名工人进进出出。
More than hundreds of workers walking in and out every day.
但是你是令我印象最深刻的，因为你每一天都会跟我打招呼，然后回的时候也会跟我讲拜拜。
But I remember you very clearly because you are the only one who greet me in the morning, saying hi, and you say bye to me after work every day.
当全世界的全部人、全工厂的人都看我是透明的时候，只有你看到我。
When everyone in this factory treats me like nobody.Like I'm not there. You are the only one who sees me.
今天早上你有跟我讲 good morning.
You said good morning to me this morning.
但是我一放工了，我没有看到你跟我讲拜拜哦。
But I didn't see you after work today. You didn't say goodbye to me.
所以我就猜想一定有一些事情发生。
And I thought something was wrong.
所以我就去找找看。
That's why I decided to enter the factory and find out.
弟兄姐妹
so brothers and sisters,
我相信我们每一个人都要成为一个好人。
I believe every one of us wants to be a good person.
我们都想成为上帝眼中那个良善的人。
We all want to be the good person in the eye of God.
但是不是靠着我们的力量。
But we can't do it with our own strength.
要有，记得是要圣灵的充满，你才能够活出这样子的果子的生命。
Yes, we need to be filled with the Holy Spirit. Only then we can live out the life of the fruit of the Holy Spirit.
所以求主帮助我们，要活出忍耐，要活出恩慈，要活出良善。
Yes, may the Lord help us to live out patience, kindness, and goodness.
讲了六个，下次再讲最后三个。
Yes, we've talked about the six qualities of the fruit of Holy Spirit. We're going to continue with the three others.
我们祷告。
Let's pray.
主，我们感谢你。
Lord, we thank you.
你的话是充满着能力的。
Your word is full of power.
很多时候我们在面对生活的困难的时候
，When we face difficulties in our daily life,
我们很容易放弃。
It's easy for us to give up.
但是你教导我们要在患难中学习忍耐。
But Lord, you've taught us to learn to endure in sufferings.
不只是要忍耐，也要有恩慈和良善。
Not only we should endure and have patience, we should also have kindness and goodness.
虽然很多时候讲是很容易的。
It's always easier said.
但是当每次我们要做出来的时候，求你的灵来帮助我们。
It's always easier said than done, but may your Holy Spirit help us.
让我们不断的学习，有一天真的是能够达到你眼中的那个良善。
Help us to keep learning, and that one day we can have the goodness in your eyes.
愿你帮助我们每一位弟兄姐妹。
Help each and every brother and sisters here.
当我们活出你的话的时候，也能够经历你话语的美好。
As we live out your word, may we also experience the goodness
我们这样子感谢祷告奉主耶稣基督的名。
We ask and pray all this in Jesus' name.
Amen.